Hey, this is Cliff and Matt. Right now we're going to show you how to pot a cutting. They're all different sizes, all different shapes too, on epiphyllums. I'm going to show you how to cut them also, and how to root a small cutting. Okay. Well, we have a plant here. I'm going to show you. It's already well established. I'm going to put it front here. Right here, I'll show you here. There's the name of it. Zoots. Can't remember pronounce these things. I'm bad with these kind of words. Anyway, so I'm gonna take one cutting off of this whole plant. I've got some cuttings down here, but I'm gonna take one cutting off of this plant to show you where you would cut it. Roughly about 6 inches down, and usually where a joint is. This is our joint here. We've taken a cutting off here prior to that was sticking up about that far. I'm going to cut it right about there. That's good. And let's take this and set this down. Okay. Now, don't forget to write down the name of your cutting before you do anything else, because you won't know what the cutting is. So do one cutting attempt or one plant at a time. Okay, it's wet right now, so I got to dry it out. And we use a magic marker on the actual plant itself, the stem, because it lasts for a long time and you won't lose the name off of it. And also the date. Also put the date on, it's very important. This one was the zoots. Still too wet. That's too wet. Now, but that's how you do the cutting. Off a bigger plant. Okay. Okay, here's some cuttings. The cutting I just showed you here is just cut, just now. And this one you want to let heal over. Healing over means let it callus on the bottom here. Let it callus over for roughly 2 weeks. Keep it in a cool area, not too cold, not in a refrigerator or anything like that, but in a garage, but not too hot. You want it in a cool area, oh, I don't know, in the backyard or something like that. And a ventilated area, something to keep it sort of heal over for you. But roughly 2 weeks to let that heal over on the bottom. You don't want to plant it like this because it will rot. It'll rot the base. If you plant it just directly into a pot, it'll rot the base and you won't get any growth. So let it heal over, very important. Okay, move on. Here is a whole bunch of cuttings that we took 2 to 3 weeks ago, and these are actually buds that are going to come out of this stem real soon. This actually this spring. It's January the 19th right today, or 18th. And this is a really good cutting. It's roughly 8-10 inches, right around there. And it's cut at an angle. See how we cut this at an angle? That's to get more growth from in this area, these two areas here. Okay, and if it's a triangle growth, just go ahead and cut flat, because you're not going to be able to make a point to it like this. By also making a point, it'll stick in the pot much better, and it'll hold up straighter better too. Okay, and also make sure you put the date when you planted it and the name right on the plant. Okay. Okay. We'll just take a basic 4-inch pot. Doesn't matter. It could even be a clay pot, but make it small. Make it a small pot. And then the other thing is, when you put the soil in, you put in a little bit of soil, which we have here, already mixed up. And I tend to tamp it down a little bit on the bottom to slow the water from coming out the base faster. It's too fast. Okay, about half full of soil mix. And then you could put in 2 or even 3 into a 4-inch pot if you want to. You'll get faster growth if you do, but you could put it in with 1. I'm going to put it in with 1 right now. Okay, bring it over to here. About 2 inches deep in the pot. Okay, set it in the middle. You don't want it to touch the sides. That'll help rot better. I mean, rot. You don't want it to rot, period. So put it in the middle. I'm not going to show you like that. But... and just fill it up with soil all the way around. Keep the plant in the center. Like that. Not too much soil. Just a little bit. And pack it down just a little bit. Don't go crazy packing it. But just so it can hold itself up. Okay? And I've still got an inch of area for water to sit in there. But you're not going to water it. You're going to let it sit just like this for probably, up to 3 weeks to a month maybe. You don't know. But you can mist it. Okay? You can mist it, but don't water it. But you can mist it with a spray bottle. Okay? But spray just the plant. Just the stem itself. Spray. Like once a week, depending on how hot it is outside. If it's summertime, you're going to be watering it a little bit more. If it's wintertime, maybe less, depending on how much heat there is in the air and sun. And after you've planted it, you want to put it in a shady location, with not too much. Filtered sun's really good, like underneath the tree or underneath the patio is great too. And not too much heat. Main thing is not too much heat on these. I'm going to show you another plant. Let's plant one more so you can keep an idea how to do it. Put a little bit of soil in the bottom. Pack it down a little bit. This one I'm going to put two in. Just because I want faster growth. So, oh, we forgot to cut this one. But it's okay. You don't have to have them cut like this. You can, okay? We prefer this way. But you can also cut them flat. If you prefer that way too, that will work also. Both ways will work. This will just work better for you and get growth faster. Okay, so you can put them in, separate them. A little bit of soil like I showed you, 2 inches deep, roughly 2 inches, not too far. A little bit of soil between everybody. About 1 inch of water area. When it gets started, it'll grow better. So you need to leave that opening of 1 inch to be able to put water in the bottom. Eventually, not right away. Like I said, don't water it. If you can mist it, that's okay. That's what they'll look like when they're done. Now you want to make sure you can leave that on there, but we also put a label in the plant container itself, because then we can see it faster and we know how he's doing. We forgot to put a date on there.